Xbox One. Xbox One. Microsoft. Yeah, so everything I really want to say, actually, this video is kind of pointless for me because I could not really do a better job than Angry Joe. Check out Angry Joe's, if you haven't already, I'm pretty sure a lot of people have already watched it. It's got like, you know, hundreds of thousands of views, which is great, because he did such a passionate, eloquent job of talking about Xbox One's policies regarding its, you know, digital distribution and its, you know, need for internet connection. Yeah, that's pretty much how I feel. I'm just not able to deliver it so well as him, because Microsoft done fucked it up. It's true. They fucked this up so bad for consumers. But the problem is, they're probably still going to be really successful, and with Xbox One. It's bullshit. It is bullshit. But they are a company. They are doing, you know, because it's really upsetting that they are taking this route to me. It is totally ignoring the people that made at least the Xbox brand what it is. Xbox brand is expanding. It is also being really restrictive. You know, it is trying to be that digital distribution console. And last time a console tried to do that, it didn't go so well. Remember PSP Go? Or PS Go or something like that? The portable PSP that was digital distribution only. Yeah, not a lot of people remember that anymore. But that didn't work out so well. It wasn't the right time. I still don't think it's not the right time for it. At least now it will be. It has a higher chance of being successful. I can understand Microsoft's reason for wanting it so that, you know, you get a game and it just downloads onto the hardware, and therefore it is kind of like, you know, you're renting a game. You can use the game, you can use the license of the game. I understand kind of why it's like that now. Because for Microsoft, the big money maker for Microsoft is Xbox Live. And so it makes sense for Microsoft to make profit, to continue their level of profit, to cater only to people with internet, and only to people who are potential Xbox Live subscribers. It makes sense, but at the same time, doing that totally alienates the rest of the audience that doesn't give a that can't, you know, not, okay, they, you know, they do care about Xbox Live, but that can't use Xbox Live all the time. To have a console where, you know, after a day of being offline, you can't play any games on it anymore, to have a console like that is just scary and terrifying and total bullshit. It is definitely something to gripe about, something to be angry about. No consoles, no hardware should ever be designed this way. If it's an online service, it makes sense. If it's just a service, if it's on Live, because that is a service, that is not a console you buy, it makes total sense. Netflix, that is not a hardware something you buy, it makes total sense. It's service that you pay for every month or every year. It is service. Xbox One is not just a service. It is a fucking big box of metal and plastic that you have inside your own home. So imagine, you know what, this is a very short-term investment if you're buying Xbox One. It's very short-term investment. What I mean by that is you buy this console and you buy games on it, and Microsoft, maybe it has an 8-year plan. For 8 years, it keeps the servers up, and then it's time for Microsoft to release a new console. And I don't know whatever the hell they're gonna call, what they're gonna name the next console. I have no idea. Xbox Master of them all. I don't know. Master Xbox. I'm gonna call it that. So they release Master Xbox. What happens then? what happens might be, you know, they might shut down the servers for Xbox One. And in which case, Xbox One is totally, completely useless to play games. You can still watch Blu-ray, and you can still watch DVDs, and you can still watch TV with it. Which is weird, because it's supposed to be, Xbox brand is a gaming brand, but after 8 years, you can't play games on it because they closed down the servers to allow you to play games. Yeah, short-term investment. Look, people, you can still eBay for a Atari 5600, right? Atari 5600. Retailers no longer sell Ataris, no longer sell Super Nintendos. Those are outdated consoles. But guess what? You can still do on them as long as they're not broken. You can still play games on them. That is a long-term investment. You bought a console, you can play games on it, even without internet. Wow. Even without internet. Xbox One, that's not going to be the case. So there's people out there that are like, you guys already have internet, you guys are watching this YouTube video, so what's the problem? What is the problem? You're going to be connected anyway, you're always going to be connected, so it doesn't matter. But this totally ignores the market, where people don't have either a good internet connection, or people who travel a lot. Xbox One is huge. You know, a PS3 is a pain in the ass to you know, take around the airport. It really is. It has a weird shape. It is really heavy, really big. It's just a pain in the ass. And it's actually bigger than the 360, right? Xbox One looks even bigger than the PS3. People who are traveling all the time, Xbox One just feels like a horrible choice to purchase just for that. But even beyond that, you know, if they have to be at a hotel for, you know, 4 days at a time, there are people like this who live this way. You know, people who are always on the move and they like to game. Good luck. You can game for about the first day of your traveling, and after that, you can't really game on your Xbox One anymore. I guess for those people, I suggest portable consoles, and actually, I suggest, you know, relying on your iPhone or your Android phone, because games on phones nowadays are pretty remarkable. I'm so amazed now by what these phones are able to do. Even just typical Endless Runners now are, I was blown away like last month when I tried out Temple Run 2 for the first time. I was just like, wow, this is amazing. Even though it's an Endless Runner, and I know those get a lot of flack, but Endless Runners are actually fun and addictive, and it's the perfect type of game to play on your phone. So there's that. This always having a console requiring an internet connection to be able to play games on it is a horrible, 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 the most anti-consumer idea ever conceived. Good luck with that. I'm never ever going to buy Xbox One for that reason. If I have a friend who bought it, I'll check it out and just kind of, you know, play it for a while for that reason. But no, me buying it myself, not gonna happen. Also not gonna happen for privacy concerns. Because now with the whole this Patriot Act and with this whole Prism data mining system, who knows what the US government can do with all the stuff that Kinect has recorded. And Microsoft, they say now that they're not going to sell the recorded Kinect information to other companies. They say that now, but if you look at the bottom of their official policies release, it's like, these terms and these policies might change in the future. Might be discontinued in the future. Did you see that line, that fine print? So that some people are excited about that fine print. It's like, oh, that means this whole internet, always needing internet connection, might be discontinued. Might be a good thing. But it might also mean that this, you know, its policies might change for the worse. And when usually companies put a fine print like that, such a tiny fine print that people usually look over, usually that's not a good thing, because it usually turns out to be for the worse. And then the whole used game thingy, there's no longer going to be allowed to be you know, rental companies are no longer able to use Xbox One, which is really, really, I don't know, the whole way Xbox One is handling used games situation is just weird and it's just bullshit. Really, totally bullshit. They had to do this. It's also, I feel kind of bad for, I don't know whether publishers, on the one hand, I guess publishers get to take out, you know, if they choose to not support used games, they can do that. They can make it so that people can't buy used games version of their, whatever their game they just made. But at the same time, they have to like stamp, you know, the manufacturer of the discs so that it has to be verified on the internet. I mean, the whole process, manufacturing process of games, sounds like a complicated nightmare to me, but I don't make games, so I don't know anything about that, but I just feel like it just, oh man, on one thing I will say about Microsoft is that I'm glad they at least released this statement, so at least they at least know what they're planning to do, so this is a good way to do, you know, they weren't upfront about everything. It wasn't like a spokesperson saying it. That would have been actually cooler if they had an announcement with an actual spokesperson talking about it instead of just releasing this very corporate, very fakey statement on their blog, on the website. So people have to interpret all these just corporate statements, whatever. But at least they did that. Sony right now is remaining silent, and that's bothersome to me, because nobody knows what Sony's plan is with their consoles. Sony has said things that sound good. They're like, oh yeah, you can play used games. So PS4 is gonna allow you to play used games without a problem. But the thing is, that's what exactly Microsoft said before they released the official press statement. So not impressed. And, you know, Sony said, the DRM policies will be left to up to the publishers. Well, that is exactly what Microsoft is saying right now. What the fuck, Sony? Like, I hope PS4 is nothing like, PS4's policies will be nothing like Microsoft's. I hope that PS4's policies will be like Nintendo's on this. Nintendo seems to be the only console manufacturer that understands that gamers should be able to rent games, play used games, and play their games 20 years down the road on that console without needing an internet connection. Apparently, Nintendo Wii U is actually the only game console now, depending on what Sony does with their PS4. It's already established what Nintendo Wii U does, and, you know, it's established. There is no debacle about its used game policy or its DRM policies or needing internet connection. We don't. Nintendo Wii U is settled. It's good. It's the typical game console. The way it should be. The way it should be. Oh, really, that's kind of, I think I had one more thing to say, but I kind of forgot. Let me kind of take a sip of this and try to remember. No, I don't remember it. But yeah, that's really all I gotta say. Microsoft and Sony.